And the third and the most complex coping mechanism is freezing or to giving up. People are blocking not only their emotions, but their physical pain as well. They're blocking all the feelings inside of their physical body. The pain is so big that our brain is blocking the sensation of pain so we don't feel it. Examples from our real life. A child who is silently waiting in a room night after night for an abuser who come and rape her. A woman who is allowing her husband to hit her again and again and who does not talk about it, who does not leave it. She's not fighting, she's not running away, she's just allowing him to hit her. Third example, a war veterans who can spend hours lying in bed without saying a word. They're just blocking their feelings, they're blocking their body, they just existing in this world without feeling anything physically or emotionally. Fourth example, a victim of sexual abuse who cannot say a word about what happened. They don't even remember. They can say that they were in their room trying to go to bed, and then they can remember themselves in a hospital, all in blood, and they don't remember what had happened. So they are blocking their feelings on their physical body. They are blocking their memory, emotions, feelings, and physical sensations. This is called freeze reaction or giving up mode. In this freeze mode, a person is blocking the pain so they can survive. They're giving up their body to the abuser. They're not trying to escape. They're not trying to fight back. They might not even remember what has happened to them. In the book, The Body Keeps the Score, the author says that our right hemisphere develops first, and the brain, the right hemisphere, is responsible for images, for our feelings, for our emotions. The left brain or the left hemisphere is responsible for logic, for the ability to name our emotions, for the ability to analyze the situation. In the case of deep trauma, such as PTSD or sexual abuse, our left brain is getting blocked. When people are trying to recall traumatic event, everything feels exactly as it was when the event had happened, even if it was 10 years ago. So their right hemisphere is working. They can remember images, they can remember feelings, they can remember emotions, but they are as strong as they were 10 years ago. And some people cannot remember anything at all. So even the right hemisphere is blocked. They don't even remember those images, even if the event was vivid and very, very emotionally charged. If you think about the child development, our left hemisphere is becoming active when a child is learning how to speak. Before that time, the child is crying, a child cannot really understand cause and effect. Only when a child is about 2, 3 years old, he's learning to speak, he's learning how to explain himself, how to communicate. This is the time when our left hemisphere is becoming active. The child is learning how to process and analyze the situation, how to understand the cause and effect at the age of 6, 7, 8, 9, sometimes 10 years old. Some people cannot remember their childhood, and because of that, they cannot understand why they end up in toxic relationship in adulthood. Some information is blocked from them. The good news that often we don't need to remember negative event. We don't need to remember the trauma. The beauty of therapy is that our trauma can be healed using our right brain. One of the methods that I like to use is art therapy. Another method is movie therapy. Third method is initiation therapy or guided meditation. All of these methods are working with our right hemisphere. So we are creating new images, we are creating new experience, we are working with visualization and symbols and archetypes. We are creating new experiences and we're discussing these new experiences during therapy. So we are connecting our right hemisphere with the left hemisphere. We're creating those new bridges between our new experiences and our logic. And when we connect to our physical body, we can see the healing process. The goal and the beauty of therapy is that we can talk about our feelings and emotions in a safe environment. We are rewriting our own history often without going back to our childhood and without experiencing the pain. We are creating a story with a new happy ending. I've seen many times how people have changed their lives for better. I've seen how they heal from toxic abusive relationships, how they become successful, and how they improve their boundaries with other people. I would like to invite you on this wonderful self-development and self-discovery journey. I encourage you to check out my online courses and my free guided meditations. You can start today. There is nothing to lose. My guided meditations are free. I have more than 10 free self-development webinars on YouTube. You can start right now, right here. And most of my guided meditations will only take 15 minutes of your time a day. When you're ready to go deeper, I will be happy to see you on my online courses and private sessions. I also offer drawing marathons where we work with symbols. We use different coloring tools and draw a picture, creating a new experience, bringing new emotions and new feelings. This is an incredible method for working with your self-esteem to heal your inner child and even to work with your limiting beliefs regarding money. All the links you can find in the description of this video. I'm sure you have some questions and maybe concerns. Your opinion matters. Please write your questions in the comment section. If you don't write your questions, I'm not able to help you. Let's help each other. Please share this video with your friends. Share it on your Facebook, social media, Instagram, Twitter, via email. If you find this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel by clicking the notification bell. Your opinion matters, and I'm looking forward to seeing your comments, seeing your likes, and seeing your questions. If you have a private question, you can submit it on my website, lenasemenek.com. Again, my name is Lena Semenek, and this is Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. Until next time, bye.